Welcome to part 4 of Fundamentals of CR Basic Programming. In this video, I will discuss operators and logical expressions and how they are used for simple program control, such as turning a heater or cell modem on and off. In programming, an operator is a symbol that represents an action or process, like add, divide, equal to, less than, or greater than. There are different types of operators in CR Basic. Mathematical operators, such as add or multiply, change the value of a variable. Comparison operators, such as equal to or greater than, are used to compare the values of two variables, constants, or expressions against each other. Logical operators like AND, NOT, and OR are used to evaluate conditions in order to determine which action to perform. AND is used when two conditions must be true for an action to occur. NOT is used when any condition except the specified condition will trigger an action. OR is used when either condition can be true for an action to occur. To view a list of all the operators, open the CR Basic Help and choose Operators from the drop-down menu in the instruction panel. I will begin with a simple program that measures the data logger panel temperature and a thermocouple. As I expand my program, I will make use of operators to control how the program functions. First, I will demonstrate how the equal sign can be used as both an assignment operator and a comparison operator. I will add a new public variable called delta T. This variable will store the temperature difference between the thermocouple temperature and the panel temperature. Now I'll add an expression in the main scan between scan and next scan to calculate delta T. Delta T equals TC temp minus P temp. In this case, the equal sign is an assignment operator for the delta T variable. I'll save this program as logic example. Now I will send this program to my CR1000X data logger. This data logger has no data to save, so I can skip saving data. Once the program compiles, I will view the data in the public table. I see the panel temperature, the thermocouple temperature, and delta T, which is the difference between the two temperatures. Seeing small changes in delta T is normal with small fluctuations in the two temperature measurements. If I heat the thermocouple by holding it, I will see TC temp and the delta T increase. This tells me the program is working correctly and the thermocouple is wired properly. Next, I will use the equal sign as a comparison operator to control the status of a flag variable. I will start by adding a comment to the program to describe what I'm doing. This will help me if I come back to review or edit the program in the future. Now, I will add a public Boolean variable named flag. A Boolean variable can only have two states, true or false. Numerically, true is represented by -1 and false is represented by 0. The connect screen converts any non-zero value to true and 0 to false. Next, I will enter an expression to set the flag to true when delta T is greater than or equal to 2. My line of code reads flag equals delta T is greater than or equal to 2. In this expression, the equal signs is an assignment operator for the flag variable and a comparison operator in the expression. Either delta T is equal to 2 or greater, or it isn't. The flag is set to true if delta T is 2 or greater. As I review the program, I can see the program indentation has shifted because I added new lines of code. So this is a good place to show how to rebuild the indentation. CR Basic uses indentation to make it easier to follow the program logic. I can include the indentation manually by using Tab or the spacebar. I can also have CR Basic rebuild the indentation automatically by selecting Rebuild Indentation from the Edit menu, or by pressing Ctrl-I to have CR Basic set the indentation for every line. Next, I will save the program again and send it to the data logger. Now, when I view the public table, I see the flag status in the table. The flag remains false as long as delta T remains less than 2. As soon as delta T reaches 2.0 or greater, the flag changes to true. When delta T drops back below 2.0, flag changes back to false. This verifies the expression in the program is working as expected. Now I will demonstrate another way to use conditional logic in a program. Since I'm going to use the same condition in a different way, I will add a single quote at the front of the current expression to turn it into a comment. Commenting out lines of code is a good way to test different lines in a program. This time, I will use an if-then statement to set the status of the flag variable based on the evaluation of an expression. There are three keywords to an if-then statement: if, then, and endif. The condition I wish to check is placed between if and then. Since I'm checking for the same flag status as before, I can copy the delta T comparison operator and paste it here. Next, I will add any actions I require if my condition is true in the space above and if. I want flag to be set to true, so I enter flag equals true as my action. This will only happen if delta T is greater than or equal to 2.
Now I can save the program and send it to the data logger.
When I view the public table, I see the flag change to true as soon as delta T goes above 2, as expected. But watch what happens when delta T goes back to less than 2. The flag variable stays true because I instructed the data logger to set the flag true when delta T is 2 or greater. But I didn't specify what the flag status should be when delta T falls below 2 again. With the current program, once delta T is true, it will stay true until I manually set it to false. Now I will add an else statement to specify what flag status should be when the condition is no longer true. The else statement lets me add instructions that will only be executed if delta T is not greater than or equal to 2. I will enter flag equals false as my action. Now the flag will return to false when the delta T condition is no longer true. I will save the modified program and send it to the data logger again to test the logic. Flag begins as false. As I hold the thermocouple, delta T increases and goes above 2. As it does, flag changes to true. When I let go of the thermocouple, delta T drops back below 2 and flag returns to false. The program logic works as it should. That's the power of an if-then statement. A condition is checked, and two entirely different conditional responses can be performed based on the value returned. In this example, it's easy to see the flag status change simply by holding the thermocouple until delta T rises to 2 or greater. But what if the condition that controls flag status is delta T is greater than 100, or some other condition that is not easy to achieve at my desk? Fortunately, I can test any condition by manually setting it in the public table. But before I can do manual tests with the delta T variable, I must first comment out the expression that sets delta T, and then resend the program. If I don't do this, the program will continually overwrite what I enter manually in the public table. Now I can test if the logical expression in the program is working correctly by changing delta T to any value I want to test in the public table, and verifying that flag status changes as expected. Once I'm done checking different values of delta T, I need to edit the program again to remove the comment symbol from the delta T expression so the flag status will be controlled by the program automatically. In summary, in this video I have defined operators and shown where to find them in the CR Basic Help, and I have demonstrated how operators are used in logical expressions to process instructions conditionally, based on the evaluation of an expression. I have also demonstrated how to test whether logical expressions are working correctly by commenting out the expression in the program, and then setting the condition manually in the public table. Watch one of the many Campbell Scientific videos or contact Campbell Scientific directly to get any questions answered.